Good morning, all of you. My name is Karthik Kumar. Welcome to Sri Sarvananda School, and I am dealing the subject chemistry for the class 8. And the chapter name is General Organic Chemistry. Coming to the topic, today's topic is nomenclature of organic compounds. And what is the previous topic? In the previous class, we discussed the type of functional groups with the general formula along with some examples including with the structural formula. Now coming to the nomenclature, what is the meaning of nomenclature? Giving of name to the organic compound. First of all, what is the organic compound? Organic compound that contain carbon, hydrogen, sometimes along with oxygen. For example, glucose, C6H12O6. Now, for each and every organic compound, there will be one fixed name with a defined structure. Now, that fixed name is followed by the satisfying rules of IUPAC. IUPAC represents International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Now, for each and every organic compound, whether if the given organic compound that contain a cyclic or acyclic, whether it may contain functional group or multiple bonding or substituent or multifunctional groups, etc. For each and every one, there will be one fixed, defined name along with the structure. Now, what is the basic structure of a nomenclature? For that one, prefix plus word root plus suffix. Now, prefix again, my classmate in the here, secondary prefix, primary prefix, word root can also be called as root word. Word root can also be called as root word. Suffix again my classmate into primary suffix and secondary suffix. Secondary suffix. Then first of all, what about the secondary prefix? It tells about the information of substituent. It tells about the information of substituent or substitution. Substituent or substitution. Now, what about primary prefix? Primary prefix, whether the given compound is cyclic or acyclic. If it is cyclic, then the prefix, the primary prefix is cyclo. If it is acyclic, then primary prefix is acyl. Now the given organic compound, we have to identify whether it is open chain or closed chain. If it is closed chain, then a primary prefix is considered as cyclo. Then what about the root word or word root? Root word or word root, it gives the number of carbon atoms. Number of carbon atoms in a main chain, nothing but the skeletal chain of a minimum position of functional group or multiple bonding or substituent with the decreasing order of their priority, with the decreasing order of priority. What is the priority principle? Functional group is greater than, multiple bonding is greater than substituent. Then what about the primary suffix? Primary suffix, it gives the information about whether the given compound is saturated or unsaturated. If it is saturated, then carbon and carbon may form the single bond. Then it is considered as AN. A carbon forms single bond with carbon, its hybridization is sp3 hybridization. Now whether it may contain a carbon double bond carbon, carbon double bond carbon, then primary suffix is en. Here it is the type of hybridization sp2. The two carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized. Now carbon triple bond carbon, the suffix given as ina, suffix given as ina with the hybridization sp, with the hybridization sp. Then what about the secondary suffix? Secondary suffix, it gives the information of a functional group. In the previous class we have discussed the definition of functional group is the group of atoms the present on the organic compound that will give the peculiar properties of the given compound. Hence that is the considered as functional group. And what are the various functional groups we discussed in the earlier class. Now coming to first part, that is secondary prefix. Okay, as earlier we discussed that secondary prefix gives the information of substituent or it will undergo substitution. While taking an example with the bond line formula, its condensed formula is considered as CH3, CH2, CH3. In the main chain of the carbon atom, it may contain a total number of carbon atoms are 4. Then its root word is considered as butyl. Now there is no substituent. No hydrogen atom was replaced with another substituent or any functional group. It doesn't contain any multiple bond. Now for this one, the name is given as open chain, that is it is considered as butyl ene. Now butyl represents here what root, ene represents primary suffix. There is no functional group and it is represented by hydrocarbon. While taking another example with the bond line formula, one substituent. Now the numbering of carbon atom 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, or from right side to 1 2 3 4. Now the prefix or suffix should be at the minimum position. The numbering have to give from left side 1 1 2 3 4. Now here it is a methyl group. For that the name is given as, first of all the condensed formula is CH3 CH2 CH3. Okay, for this one 2-methyl, nothing but the secondary prefix at C2, second locant of a carbon. 2-methyl, root word but, primary suffix ene, secondary suffix hydrocarbon. Now in the same way, while taking the bond line formula along with methyl, along with Cl. Now here it may contain two functional groups, either from left side to second carbon or from right side to also second carbon. Then for this one, the numbering you have to give by following the alphabetical principle generally. Now methyl starts with M, chloro starts with C. Hence the numbering given here 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-chloro-3-methyl-butane. 2-chloro-3-methyl-butane. Here the total number of prefixes are 1 and 2. Coming to the priority order, first will come chloro, second methyl. Now while taking one more example with the bond line formula, one of that is methyl, another one is OH and Cl, and the remaining OH, Cl And here it is methyl. Now in this case, OH is considered as functional group, methyl and chloro. These two are considered as a secondary prefix. Secondary prefix. Further, the general list of secondary prefix. Cl represents here chloro. Cl represents chloro. Br represents bromo. F represents fluoro. I represents iodine. Now generally X represents here halo of 7th group, related to 7th group. Now while writing here CH3, here it is considered as methyl. Now CH2, CH3, it is considered as ethyl. After removing hydrogen atom from each and every alkane, you will get the alkyl, that is represented by R. Alkyl. Generally, NO2 represents nitro. Further prefix is, secondary prefix is nitro. And NO represents nitroso. OCH3 represents methoxy. OCH2, CH3 represents ethoxy. Now OR represents here alkoxy. It is the secondary prefix related to the functional group ether. What is the general formula of ether? ROR dash. Either R and R dash may equal or different. Now coming to primary prefix. What is the second one here in the basic structure? Primary prefix. Primary prefix gives the information whether it is cyclic or acyclic. Cyclic or acyclic. Now here, if it is cyclic, then the secondary prefix is cyclo. If it is acyclic, the compound is doesn't have primary prefix. While taking the example, 6-member ring, it is a closed chain. Closed chain. Hence its name is given as cyclohexane. Now here cyclo represents primary prefix. There is no secondary prefix in the given structure. Now coming to the root word, that is hexane. Hex. Number of carbon atoms. An represents carbon and carbon single bond. Now small e represents here hydrocarbon, absence of functional group. In the given structure, there is no functional group, multiple bonding and substituent. Now while taking one more example, here it is considered as CH3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hexane, no double bond. Now here it is not cyclic, hence primary prefix is absent. Now here primary prefix is cyclo. While taking one more example for that cyclohexane, one of the hydrogen atom is replaced with the methyl group. Hence that methyl considered as a secondary prefix. What is the secondary prefix here? Methyl. After the secondary prefix, primary prefix is cyclo. Methyl cyclo. Hence the root word is 6-member ring. Main skeleton that contain total number of carbon atoms are 6. Hence hexane will come. There is no double bond in the main skeleton. An. No functional group. E. Methyl cyclohexane. Methyl cyclohexane. This is the IUPAC name of the given structure. Now in this class, we have discussed the nomenclature of organic compounds and the basic structure of the nomenclature, prefix, word root, suffix. General discussion given, along with the some examples related to the secondary prefix as well as primary prefix. Thanks for watching.